Hello and welcome back. This week we're going to talk about something that a lot of people really don't think about, and that's how the shape of your fabric will affect the way that a finished garment will turn out. Most people expect that because fabric is flat and you put it together with another piece of fabric, it will also be flat. These exceptions are if you're doing gathers or something like that, where it's very obvious that there's something happening with the fabric and it's coming together in a way that causes it to become more three-dimensional. But there are other ways that fabric becomes more dimensional. For example, the way something is cut. Like, this is a corset that I've been working on. I started this earlier today. And this is most of one side of it. As you can see, this piece is very curved. Very curvy. This actually goes into the lower back, and that's over the hip and into the buttocks area. And then that is the upper back. So it should have that nice curve to it. But this piece is very straight and very flat. I'm actually going to just be pinning this in place here so you can see how the shape of this will affect the shape of this and cause it to bow out and become that nice curved shape. And because it is a corset, things are done a little bit awkwardly, or at least how I do it. The line that I have here, the chalk line, is actually the waistline. And what I'm going to do is it's folded back, so this is going to be sandwiched in between these two pieces, which is the fashion fabric and the coutil. The coutil is the main stabilizing fabric that actually takes most of the strain. But I want those blue lines to line up so that the strain stays along that waistline. So to be able to do that, I set the edge of what's folded back against the edge of this and adjust until those blue lines meet. So it becomes one continuous line. And then I kind of hold that in place and flip the whole thing over and stick a pin in it. Which may not be the proper way to do it, but it's how I do it. Therefore, it is good enough. It works for me. Other people have other ways to do it, I am sure. However, now that the one pin is in place here, which is kind of hard to see because of the fabric, I do apologize for that. I'm going to move down this direction. And all I'm doing is lining up the edge of the turned fabric with the raw edge of this fabric. And then again, putting a pin in. This does take a little bit of patience and practice because it is already starting to throw out some dimensional shape. And I'm making sure to get through all of the layers of the fabric. Then because there is another curve at the bottom, I'm going to put one at the very bottom here. Normally, if it was a piece that was meant to lay flat, I wouldn't put one down at this bottom edge. But because it is very dimensional, there does need to be an extra pin there. And then I'm going to do the same thing going up this direction. So line up the edges. snap this over into place. That should be laying flat, and it's not. And it's because it is becoming dimensional. This is what's commonly known as fabric manipulation. And it is literally the manipulation of the fabric in different ways to ensure that it does become more three-dimensional. Three of the layers, but not all four. There we go. Ow. Ow. This should be easier because it's a much straighter edge. Which means I probably should have gone this direction first, but I didn't. Oh well. I'm struggling with my pins because honestly, the pins that I have are too large, they're too thick, and they are not very sharp because I've had them for years. But when you're working with a very tightly woven fabric like the coutil is, the structural layer, you should have a thin needle, a fine needle or fine pin, and it should be sharp. There we are. Now, as you can see, even just pinning that in place and not having stitched anything down, that's coming up actually off of the table completely. It's got a lot of shape and dimension to it. Now, I am going to actually adjust from here down because this should be laying smoothly. Actually, that should be fine. It's when I pull it smooth, when I pull this flat and pull it smooth, it's mostly smooth. Got a little bit here that needs adjusting on the top layer, but it's flat on the bottom because, again, that's a stiffer fabric, so it's going to stay flatter. But that is how simply and how easily just the shape of the fabric that you cut is going to affect the finished shape of the product, of the thing that you are creating. It's something that a lot of people don't expect, especially with commercial patterns that you buy just the paper patterns. So it can be confusing for a lot of people when they're starting to sew and starting to produce these things, especially with garments and clothing for people that have, people are round. We are not flat, we are round, we have shapes. So when you have the pattern cut out and you have the fabric cut out and you're starting to put it together like this and shapes are starting to come out of it, it can be really confusing. But this is just normal. This is what is supposed to happen in a lot of cases. I hope you've learned at least a little bit of something. I do encourage you to find me everywhere else. I am on Twitch, Twitter, Instagram. I am here all under the name Scaldsbane. Please show me what you're doing. Tag me in things. Let me know that you're trying something new and you're learning. I do appreciate it. And I hope to see you again in a couple of weeks.